Hello, if you love truth today, you're going to be misunderstood, misrepresented, slandered. So if you have zeal for the faith today, you're going to be demonized. Now, the Orthodox Church in America, known as the OCA, is a particular jurisdiction, and it is disgusting. Sometimes I cannot believe what my eyes and ears show me. Lazar Puhalo is the leader of an OCA monastery. He's actually guiding souls, Orthodox Christian souls. But Lazar himself doesn't believe in the Orthodox faith. This makes absolutely no sense. Lazar Puhalo is a modernist. He holds to theistic evolution. He blasphemed God when he suggested in a video that Adam and Eve may not have been historical personages. He totally contradicts scripture and the fathers of the church. He's not Orthodox by any stretch of the imagination. He does not have the mind of the Holy Fathers. The OCA, from what I understand, instructed him not to promote his non-Orthodox concepts, but he still has the videos up, which shows he's not repentant. He's still poisoning souls. Why does the OCA allow him to get away with this? Are they so corrupt? Are they so far gone? He's not Orthodox, yet they're allowing him to be head of an Orthodox monastery. The people who are there need to get out of that monastery. Why are his videos still up, which are scandalous? Why doesn't the OCA demand that he remove those videos? He's not truly repentant. So what's the point of them instructing him not to promote his concepts when his videos remain up? He's not repentant. He's not even Orthodox, and he shouldn't be communing at this time in his life. It's a no-brainer that in order to commune, you have to first be Orthodox. This man has little or no fear of God. St. Nihilus prophesied that in the last days, the church will be deprived of God-fearing pastors. And I think Lazar Puhalo is a precursor of what's coming, and the indifference in the OCA is a precursor of what's coming. And the reason why the OCA is like this and why Puhalo is the way he is because there's not enough protest. Orthodox Christians need to send letters to the OCA complaining about Lazar Puhalo. So it's just going to get worse. There's not going to be enough protest. You need to really love the truth. And I really enjoy Genesis, Creation, and Early Man by Father Seraph from Rose. And I remember there's a statement in there. He said something to the effect that people today do not love Christ enough to stand for the truth. And that's true. See? So Puhalo is a modernist, heretic. His heart is not right before God. He does not hold to the Orthodox faith. He does not believe in Orthodox Christianity. He's scandalous. He's selfish. And he most certainly should not be head of one of their OCA's monasteries. Doesn't the OCA care about the potential spiritual damage he could cause the monks there? This man is far worse than anything I had originally suspected. At the beginning, I thought he was just a problem because of his attack on the toll houses, but there's all kinds of problems with him. Look at my links below in the description. You absolutely cannot believe in theistic evolution as an Orthodox Christian. Orthodox and Roman Catholic historical sources preclude this. This man needs to humble himself. He lacks the requisite discernment, humility, and obedience to be a clergyman. A clergyman should be the embodiment of piety and faithfulness to tradition. This man is a disgrace, very scandalous. And if the OCA doesn't like this video critique and my other critiques of Lazar Puhalo, they should blame themselves. They created the problem. Orthodoxy teaches us to blame ourselves when things go wrong. Remember? So blame yourself. These people are a disgrace. It's utterly disgusting. I'm going to end the video now.